Guys, welcome back to the vlog. Joining me in my car today. Today is kind of exciting. I just pulled up to a garden center that I've never been to before. I feel like garden centers are so beautiful. They're full of flowers. But this one's like really cute. It has a cafe. And I'm here alone and I'm like, oh man, I wish I came with someone because it's definitely like more of an outing than anything. So I'm alone today. Rudy is working right now, and then he's actually going on a camping excursion with his dad as part of like a church thing for all the men at like their church. Yeah, so he's not with me today, so I thought I'd do something fun alone. And also, I've had these pots sitting in my garage for like, sorry, I'm looking around making sure no one's looking at me. I've had these pots sitting in my garage for a long time that need some flowers, so I'm here to go get some flowers for those. I kind of want to make it like a mix of flowers and herbs so I can utilize them for, like, you know, they can be functional and beautiful. So that's what I'm looking for. Also, all the flowers are in front of me, so I feel like I'm looking around, like, already shopping while I'm sitting in my car. Anyway, so yeah, that's what I'm doing today. And then tonight, I was trying to see if, like, one of my girlfriends wanted to hang out tonight, but everyone seems to be busy, so I think it'll just be you and I. Yeah, let's go see what they have to offer here. If it's super expensive, I'm just gonna mosey around here and then go to Home Depot or something, but I thought it would be fun just to explore. So let's go do that. Southern nights. Have you ever felt a southern night? Okay, I've got all my plants behind me. It's like 85 degrees and humid out here, but we're gonna do this. So yeah, I'll show you guys what I got. So the owner was there and she guided me through all the best things to get for the sun exposure we have here and what I just wanted in general. So we have thyme and another herb here, sage, and a beautiful kind of like butterfly sort of flower here. I think that'll go into this larger pot here. And then I'm going to put this duo of like the really tall flower and these crawlers, she called them. She says that they'll like fall over the edge into the other pot here. And I just got rosemary and mint. I'm gonna probably plant the mint into the white pot. And then she said I really need to get two separate pots for the rosemary and the mint because they get really big and they don't go anywhere. Like I'll have them for years to come as long as they're happy. So yeah, kind of purple was I guess the theme. I went in there and said I just want some color and some herbs. So let's get potting. Hopefully I have enough soil. Okay, can you tell I'm disheveled? All right, I planted as much as I could. I do need some more soil. It's looking so good, look. So this is just flowers, this plant. So we have like the big, tall, purpley, lavender looking thing in the middle. And then all these guys just kind of like fall over the edge. I do need to add more soil in there just to like secure everything. And then this one is so cute. So there's a lot of room in here for the thyme to grow. And for the sage to grow as well. But yeah, I think it looks really cute out here. I'll give you guys like an overall view of the deck. It's not like perfect yet. I need to clean up. But so when you walk outside, like these pots will be here, not that mess. And then that pot, I think I'll just center on that post with this pot sitting next to it. So not that table. So It'll be cute. Miley, wanna eat? Fisher, you wanna eat? Yes? Yes? Okay.
It is the cat's dinner time, 5 o'clock, so I need to feed them. And then I hate having like a project unfinished. So I do just want to head to Home Depot and like finish up that project today. I'd rather not have it on the books tomorrow, because tomorrow morning I am going to a yoga class with my sister-in-law, Jessica, and then after that we're gonna do a lake day, which is so exciting. So I live near a lake, which is really nice. It's not the biggest lake ever. It's pretty big. Like there are people who, like there is like boat ramps and stuff. So we don't have a boat. We only have floaties. So we're gonna go out there on some floaties tomorrow. So yeah, my day's kind of like filled tomorrow. So I'd love to finish up this flower project now. Otherwise, I don't know, I might not get to it, because actually on Saturday we're doing a camping trip. So Rudy's spending like tonight camping, then he comes home, and then we're gonna go to the mountains of North Carolina, like Boone area, for a car camping trip, and it's us and 4 or 5 other couples. There's like 10 of us total, so 4 other couples, and it's gonna be so fun. It's just one night. But long story short, I really only have today to do the flowers, and I don't want them to die because I didn't plant them properly. So yeah, I'm gonna feed the cats, run out, get that other stuff, come back, finish, and I'll either have dinner with you guys or I'll just see you tomorrow morning. Good morning, guys. Welcome to the next day. I'm in my bathroom. I'm just finishing up my makeup right now. I don't really have much planned for today. I'm trying to think of like what I want to include. I need to show you the final result for the back porch. It looks very, very cute. All the flowers came together. I did actually stop at Home Depot and I did pick up more pots too. So there's like even more flowers and more pots going on just to fill it out a little bit more. So I'm really happy with how that all came together. What's kind of been on my mind is we are hosting Rudy's little sister's boyfriend. He's coming into town and he's gonna be here for quite some time. So I'm just trying to like get the house prepped and ready for him to come. So I want to weed in the front yard, go grocery shopping, things of that nature, change the bedding, stuff like that. So kind of just like house chores. I don't know, guys. Is my life even that exciting to watch? I mean, I do actually really want to film a general Q&A with Rudy and I, because we haven't done that. So there's some basic just like details about us, like our age and stuff, I don't think I've really ever said. So I'm gonna put that out next, I believe. So after this video goes live, I think we'll do like a Q&A and you guys can just get to know us more. But anyway, I'm just finishing up my makeup. I always curl my lashes. I think one of my friends got me onto this. I did not curl my lashes and I can't even imagine like how my makeup used to look now that I do every single day. These are just the Tweezerman ones. You can get them at Target. And then my favorite mascara lately is the Say Mascara Black Noir. I like that a lot. And also, I got a compliment recently on my perfume. It's just sitting in front of me, so I thought I'd mention it. I'm a big Jo Malone fan. The Jo Malone Wood Sage and Sea Salt is my absolute favorite. Honestly, tied with the English Pear and Freesia. This one's a lot more sweet and like, maybe I'll wear that one today actually. Perfectly feminine, kind of floral. It's not sickly sweet. None of Jo Malone's perfumes are sickly sweet. They all smell very, I'm like eating it now. They all smell very, very natural. And they don't have that like slightly alcoholic undertone that I think cheaper perfumes sometimes have. So I'm a big fan. They're obviously expensive. I only have 2, but yeah. Okay, I'm gonna finish up my makeup and then I will show you the finished backyard. I'm so tired of being alone, I'm so tired
outside now on the finished deck. I think it looks really, really nice. It's very simple. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, just six pots out here. One's on the table next to me that has the rosemary, and the others are like a mix of herbs and flowers together, and I love it. And honestly, from the inside, it just makes it look that much more inviting to come out here. So very happy with the final result. If you've been debating like planting flowers, if you feel like it might be late in the season, I would suggest just do it. And actually, so many of the flowers I got from the nursery the other day were on sale because it kind of is like end of season to be doing this sort of thing. So I only spent $45 on the stuff I got from that gorgeous nursery. So that might be the case near you too. And I highly recommend it. It is so nice to just like have a space outside that encourages you to get some vitamin D. And yeah, I don't think I've ever talked about the furniture we put out here. So all this stuff, like those two sun chairs, and then we have like a big dining table here that can seat like 5 people. All this stuff we got used off Facebook Marketplace when we first moved in, and it's been great. I was specifically looking for sun chairs because Rudy and I just love to lounge in the sun. That's what we do the most. Yeah, I love it out here. It's like a little heaven. Okay, I have some bananas that are just about to go too far brown, and I'm gonna share my absolute favorite banana bread recipe with you. I have tried, I don't know, like 30 different banana bread recipes online over the years, and this one is the absolute best. It doesn't have any like secret ingredients. It's just the perfect mixture. Did you guys hear like a squeaking sound? I don't know what that is. Anyway, I'm gonna make that banana bread and I'm gonna share the recipe with you guys. So it will probably already be linked down below. But if you wanna try this banana bread, I highly recommend. People say that I found a way to make you say that you love me. Hey baby, you didn't go for that. It's a natural fact that I wanna come back. Show me where it's at, baby. I'm so tired of being alone. I'm so tired of being alone. Won't you help me, girl, soon as you can? And the pot is done. Looks really good. I'm gonna give it a try. It's still pretty warm.
Can I give it a try? A lot of banana.
Wow. We had 4 bananas.
Hello, guys. This is about the
mouth sniff test.
Sniff? You guys can't see it, but her whiskers move around.
She likes it.
Yeah. Cats love just sniffing stuff.
We're not even in the frame.
Kind of hot. Ooh, but it's really good.
It's like the best midday pick-me-up ever. I was just sitting in the little breakfast nook reading my Bible. It's a nice afternoon.
And? I thought that story was going somewhere. It's just, it's just like a...
I'm just giving an update. I was reading my Bible, now I'm eating some banana bread. I feel...
Well, honestly, it was needed after this weekend.
Joyful.
Did you record any this weekend?
No.
We went on a camping trip.
Yep.
And we did one day. Yeah, one night near the mountains of North Carolina.
Near Lake James?
Table Rock area. Mm-hmm. Anyway, it's really beautiful if you've never been, but we did car camping, which is our first time ever doing that. There's a free spot off highway, old highway 150, and we camped one night. You can stay up to 14 days for free before you have to move spots, so it's like public land. But we had a lot of our friends, like 10 people.
If you can survive 14 days in the wild, yes.
Well, we did
one. That would be hard.
But we drove our car up there.
Yeah.
So we had not just backpacking gear, but we had all of our actual car gear. So we had like patio bed, patio chair pillows, blankets.
Yeah. It was the most comfortable we've ever slept because we could just bring
the cars next to our tent.
Stuff because we didn't have to hike with it.
Maybe you'll show a photo. I'll show you a photo of like you in the tent.
I'll include whatever photos I have. But yeah, it was nice. So I think we're just generally in a good
mood. Anyway, so we're tired. I was a little tired because I drove.
I'm okay. I slept so great. After camping, even though it was a very comfy setup, like the first night home is always like, you just sleep like a rock, you know?
It's really comfortable. Well, it's just back in a comfortable space.
Okay. Fine. I'm probably gonna go grocery shopping and then make some dinner. I'll also continue reading my Bible, so. Hi, it's quite a bit later now. I just finished making dinner. I was thinking of showing the whole thing, but I already showed like the banana bread in this video, so I thought it might be boring to have too much cooking content, but you guys can tell me otherwise. But I've never made this before. It was super easy and it looks so good. I haven't tried it yet. So it's just like a heavy cream pasta with bacon, little green peas, and I added a few shrimp. I probably could have added more, but I don't usually cook shrimp and I'm not even really sure if I like shrimp. I don't know. I do like shrimp. But yeah, the bacon and the onion was kind of how I started it. And then the pasta over here, and then just added the shrimp. And then heavy cream on top, and it looks really good. And just seasoned with like salt and a little bit of olive oil. So yeah, that's what we're gonna have for dinner. And I think I might finish the vlog here. Before I do, I just wanna remind you guys, I'm pretty sure the next video that we have coming out will be like a general Q&A with Rudy and I. And I'm not, like, I haven't linked my personal Instagram to this YouTube channel yet. I don't know if I ever will. But if you guys have any questions that you'd like for us to answer in that next video, just comment them below. I mentioned Instagram because I feel like a lot of people do the whole, like, Q&A thing on Instagram and then take those questions and answer them here on YouTube. I'm just on YouTube, so just comment below. It can truly be anything. I've already put together a few questions. We're gonna answer things about the house because that's really how I started this channel, was with like the house renovation series. So a few things about the house, like what we do for a living, how we make our money, our religious background, how long we've been together, when we got married, like just stuff like that, you know? So if you guys have any burning questions, yeah, just comment them. And also, if you have any video ideas for me, just let me know. I've just been doing these like kind of at-home vlogs lately, but I'm open to other ideas. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching, as always, and I'll see you in the next vlog. Bye. I guess you know that I love you so much.